Good morning everybody, welcome to this video session. We shall be in the next 5-6 videos having a look at uniform rules for demand guarantees. We will try to cover URDG in 6 to 7 videos of our 1-hour time limit. The URDG 158 that has been in existence for the past 8-9 years has been built over URDG 458. 17 years of existence of URDG 458 along with sister publication 503, which are the model forms. 40 members from 26 countries were part of the task force that drafted the URDG, and inputs and comments were taken from 52 national committees. So that is how this new URDG 158 effective 2010 was born. This uniform rules for demand guarantees talks about application of URDG, definitions, interpretation, issue and effectiveness, independence, document versus goods, non-documentary conditions, content of the instruction, application not taken up, advising, amendments, extent of liability, variation of amount, presentation, requirements for a demand, information of demand, partial demand, multiple demands, examination of presentation, time limit, currency, transmission, extent or pay, non-complying demand, waiver and notice, reduction and termination of the value and guarantee, force major, disclaimer on effectiveness, translation, acts of another party, limits on exemptions from liability, indemnity for foreign laws and usages, liability for charges, transfer of a guarantee, assignment of proceeds, governing law, jurisdiction. The present guarantee incorporates the model forms, while the previous version had separate publications 458 and 503. URDG 158 did not merely update the 458, but these are the rules which are clearer, more precise, more comprehensive and innovative. By choosing to instruct a guarantor subject to URDG a guarantee issuance, applicants announce their ability to obstruct payment for reasons derived from the underlying relationship, which means once an applicant asks for a guarantee subject to URDG, then it is assumed that they are depending on guarantee and its terms to apply and not the underlying contract. Turning to beneficiaries, they were expected to state in general terms, but not to justify, not to establish, need not prove the nature of the applicant's breach and the performance of the underlying relationship. Beneficiaries were just to state in general terms, but not to prove applicant's breach. Applicants renounced their ability to obstruct payment, so beneficiaries were happy. Beneficiaries has to say that there was a breach in good faith, so applicants were happy. And guarantors were happy because they were assured that guarantee is independent undertaking, that their commitment was subject only to its own terms, and so guarantors were insulated from the performance contingencies and guarantee is independent of the underlying relationship. So this is how the URDG 158 expects to be having more adoption than the URDG 458. Application of the rules. URDG 158 applies to any demand guarantee or counter guarantee that expressly indicates it is subject to these rules. The rules are binding on all parties except so far as modified or excluded specifically. Where, at the request of the counter guarantor, a demand guarantee is issued subject to URDG, the CG shall also be subject to URDG unless expressly excluded. Guarantee does not become subject to URDG merely because counter guarantee is subject to URDG. Instructing party is deemed to have accepted the rights and obligations expressly ascribed to it in these rules when they're requesting for a guarantee or a counter guarantee subject to URDG. When new guarantees are issued and are silent about which version of URDG will apply, if it is issued after 2010, URDG 158 will apply. So basically, for any demand guarantee, URDG will apply if it says it is subject to URDG and it is binding on all concerned parties. If a guarantee is issued subject to URDG, then the counter guarantee shall also be subject to URDG. If a party is requesting issuance of a guarantee subject to URDG, then the party is expected to have accepted the rights and obligations. Guarantee does not become subject to URDG merely because counter guarantee is subject to URDG. Definitions and rules. Advising party is the one that advises a guarantee at the request of the guarantor. Applicant is a party indicated in the guarantee as having the obligation under the underlying contract. Authenticated means able to verify the apparent identity of the sender, whether the data received or remained incomplete or unaltered. Beneficiary means party in whose favor the guarantee is issued. Business day means at a place where the business is regularly open for the performance of such an act subject to these rules. Demand guarantee or a guarantee means any signed undertaking, however named or described, providing for payment on presentation of a complying demand. Document means signed or unsigned record of information in paper or electronic form. It includes demand and it includes supporting documents. Expiry, the earlier of the two, expiry date or an expiry date. So, advising party is a party who advises a guarantee, who authenticates and advises the guarantee issued by the guarantor. And the advising party acts on the instructions of the guarantor, request of the guarantor. Applicant is a party who is having obligation under the underlying relationship based on which the guarantee is issued. Authentication means able to verify the sender and able to ensure it is complete and unaltered. Beneficiary means party in whose favor the guarantee is issued, who can claim. Business day means a day on which the office of the issuer is open for performing acts subject to these rules. Demand guarantee need not have a specific name. It has to be a signed undertaking. Signed means in paper form, a physical signature or a stamp or seal, and in an electronic form capable of being authenticated. It has to provide for payment against presentation of a complying demand. So there should be a compliance for the demand that is presented. It has to be presented by the beneficiary and payment has to be permitted based on the presentation only. Document means any record in any form, including demand and supporting documents. The other definitions, expiry date or expiry event. Expiry date is a date up to which claim can be made. Expiry event is an event on which the guarantee will expire. The event is not expected to have occurred unless a document evidencing the occurrence of this event is presented under the guarantee as specified. If a document is specified, that document evidencing occurrence of that event has to be presented. If no document is specified, then the occurrence of the event should be determinable from either the information available with the guarantor on its own office or publicly available index. Guarantor means a party who is issuing the guarantee. They can issue guarantee for their own sake. Signed means either original has been authenticated on behalf of the issuer by a seal or a stamp, or in case of an electronic document, capable of being authenticated. And underlying relationship means a contract, like a bid bond or a performance contract based on which the guarantee is issued. Interpretation. Branches of the guarantor in different countries are considered to be separate guarantees. A guarantee includes a counter guarantee and any amendment. Guarantor includes the issuer as well as a counter guarantee. Beneficiary includes the party in whose favor the guarantee is issued and who can claim. If one or more originals are required, then in case of an electronic document, one document is enough. When used to determine date, the start date or end date or a duration, from, to, until, and all includes the date, while before and after excludes the date. The term within means the beginning date is not included, but the last date is included. Well-known, qualified, independent, and all, if used, it only means a party other than applicant or beneficiary can issue that specific document that has to be issued by an official or a competent authority. Issue and effectiveness. A guarantee is considered issue when it leaves the control of the guarantor. Guarantee is issued when it leaves the control of the guarantor. It is irrevocable upon issue, and even if it does not so state. A guarantee subject to URDG need not specifically say it is irrevocable. Beneficiary may present a demand from the time of issue of the guarantee, unless the guarantee explicitly states about a future date on which it will become effective. So, the guarantee is issued the moment it leaves the control of the guarantee. Any claim can be presented from that moment. It is irrevocable. Beneficiary may present from the time of issue unless the guarantee provides a later time or event. For example, in advance payment guarantee, it will say as and when, if and when provided payment is received from the beneficiary to the applicant's account with the guarantor, the guarantee is not effective and no claim can be lodged. Independence. Guarantee is independent by its very nature. It is independent of the underlying relationship. It is independent of the application. Guarantor is in no way concerned with or bound by the underlying relationship. The reference in the guarantee to the underlying relationship is only for the purpose of identification. Guarantee is not subject to claims or defenses arising from any relationship other than between guarantor and beneficiary. Guarantee is by its nature independent. Counter guarantee is by its nature independent of guarantee. Guarantee is independent. Counter guarantee is independent of the guarantee. Guarantee is independent of the guarantee application. Guarantee is independent of the underlying relationship due to which this guarantee is issued. Guarantor is not concerned or bound with the underlying relationship. Guarantee is not subject to claims or defenses arising from any relationship other than the one between guarantor and beneficiary. Reference to the underlying relationship in the guarantee is only for the purpose of identification. Guarantors deal with the documents and not with goods or the performance or anything else related in the document. So the guarantee is documentary and the guarantee is independent. Non-documentary conditions. Guarantee should not contain a condition other than the date or lapse of a period without specifying a document to indicate compliance with that condition. Guarantee should not contain a condition without specifying a document to indicate compliance with that condition. If fulfillment of that condition cannot be determined from the guarantor's own records or from the index specified, then the guarantor shall deem such condition as unstated and disregarded. If fulfillment of the condition cannot be determined from guarantor's own records or the index, such condition will be treated as not stated and disregarded. Data may appear in the document specified and presented under the guarantee, and it should not conflict with the data in the guarantee or any other non-documentary condition. Data that may appear in the document specified in and presented under the guarantee do not conflict with the data in the guarantee in respect of that non-documentary condition. Guarantee should not contain a condition without specifying a document to indicate compliance with that condition, or fulfillment of that condition should be determinable from the index specified or guarantor's own records, else such a condition will be disregarded. If the data from such a condition appears in any document specified in the guarantee and presented, it should not conflict with the data in the guarantee in respect to such non-documentary conditions. We shall take a short break.